We're back at the boat. It's April 30th. I've done a few things during the week. I put the cutting table up. Outriggers are up, obviously. I pulled it up by the shop here. Yeah, I put batteries in it the other day, two of them. And today we're gonna start some motors. So, I gotta get some stuff ready, but we'll jump up inside the boat. Oh, I did vacuum it last night, but it still needs more. And then we'll power wash it. So, lift up those two hatches. All right. There's the two engines. As you can see, they are not the original engines. The original engines would have been Ford blocks 302 or 351. These are Chevys. These were replaced in 2010, July. So this one's the one that I had problems with years ago. The fuel pump didn't want to pump, but I was told by the owner that if you prime it up, it will work. So we shall see. I'm gonna disconnect the fuel line down there in the corner and pump it up with a remote tank to get fuel into the electric fuel pump that is located right down in there, and see if I can get her to work. This is a plug for the fuel pump here. All right. We'll get some tools and we'll get started on this. Of course, I'm going to fill the carburetor up with fuel too. Okay. Got the parts that I needed. Fuel tank. Alright. Got the fuel line off. It only took a couple seconds. It's one clamp. Brush off this side here. Okay. Plugged in the tank. Alright, now look at that guy sitting there. Now I use my cheater, and we gotta use this with almost every boat. Got a little bottle of gas. And we go in through the vent. Okay. And watch for it to flow out the bottom. That's when I know that the fuel float is full, and mostly it filled with me priming it, so that's good. All right, water intake and a hose. Just go in there as far as I can. And yes, I'm gonna get some spillage, but that's okay. All right, let me go turn on the water and let's see what happens. I said there's some spillage down there. Let's see if this thing will fire. We'll set the camera back here. start up the other side. That don't sound good. All right, let's try the other one. Might have a rod knock in this one. Starboard engine, this one here, sounds like it has a rod knock. I'll have to pull the engine and get in there and see what's up with that. This one sounds pretty good. I'll double check it because it could just be a lifter too.
Thank you for watching Call of the Wild Outdoors. Please like and subscribe, and I'll be bringing more tips for outdoor enthusiasts in the future. Have a good night.